I wanted to talk about what I learned in real estate school. Oh, you know, it's not like I don't know this stuff. It's just that the way they presented it just blew me away. The number one thing I learned, I think that really stuck with me, is individuals who get into the sales business. And by the way, I got to tell you, there's a chapter in my book called The Fastest Way to a Six-Figure Income. This is in my book, 33 and a Third, Success Shortcuts. I wish someone had taught me sooner, which you can get at DaveRocket.com or Amazon or Barnes & Noble, wherever you want to look. This chapter is shocking to most people because they think, well, to get a six-figure income, you have to go to college and you have to do all these steps and you have to rise your way through an organization. Whereas I have met people who have hit their six-figure income levels within 2 years of starting in sales business. And many people choose the real estate business because it's got such a big ticket item. When you sell something, you feel it. I mean, sometimes the commission is so great that you can catch up on stuff and buy new things that you've always wanted, buy investment property. Real estate's a wonderful thing. Well, here's what I learned about the people who got their six-figure incomes in just 2 years. Was that they were humble. They were humble enough to recognize that there's about 5 major sales systems in this country, and all you need to do is pick one. It doesn't matter which one it is, and follow it to a T without any questions. And this is where my ego cost me a lot of money, is because I would take the system and I would say, oh, I can make it better, and I'll tweak it and mess with it. Whereas the humble person who accepts the system as it's written, it's been tested over 30 years worth of time, so I mean it's, they follow it to a T, and as a result their income goes up and they don't question the system. They had, I don't know, five or six people up at the front of the room, and all of them were making $500,000 a year or more. And here's the part that was just fascinating to me, as they asked each person, what's your day like as a salesperson? Everybody's day sounded similar to this. I wake up at 5 in the morning, I exercise, eat breakfast, shower. At 7:30, I have an accountability partner, and we read scripts to each other. In other words, what to do if somebody says this, and what questions to ask in this situation, blah, blah, blah. So they practice scripts from 7:30 in the morning to 8 a.m. And then at 8 a.m., between 8 and 11, they make calls. 3 hours of solid calls, no interruptions. Call, 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 call. They're calling past clients, people who maybe were on the market at one time and are not anymore. People around a new house comes on the market, so they market around that house, thinking that there might be another person want to put their home on the market, etc., till 11 o'clock. And then they have 3 appointments, 12, 2, and 4. And the activity of the first 3 hours fills in the 3 appointments of the afternoon. They're done by 6, most of them. Some of them are workaholics and work really hard. But most of them are done, and they make a tremendous amount of money. And I'm thinking to myself, well, couldn't anybody do this? Haven't you noticed, Randy, that there's some people that are so close to the edge that $500 more a month would make a world of difference to them?
Oh, yes. I think most people are in that situation. They're living fairly close to what they make, but they're spending a little bit more than they make. And if they just had that extra $500, it'd be great.
Yeah. Well, couldn't a sales business like that get them the $500? And it doesn't matter what it is you're selling. You could do network marketing or any one of those things, and by having a consistent, if I were working full-time, I would have a little section of my evening, 1 or 2 hours, that would make calls, and 1 appointment every day. And doing that, you would get 2 really good clients per week that would buy your product. And, you know, slowly over time, I would say between 2 and 5 years, you would have a very robust business.
Well, one thing stood out in what you said were some of the practices that the successful person uses. And one of them was calling or contacting past clients, but don't most people in the real estate business, like once they close a sale, I don't think they ever contact that person.
That's 100% correct. I think I saw the statistics, 80% of the people never hear from their agent again.
Yeah, and I've had that experience. I've had a number of pieces of real estate over the years, and it's not very often that I've heard from the person later. You know,
right.
So, yes.
So that would be an error on the part of the salesperson, missing out on opportunities. So, boy, I learned some lessons in real estate school, and I'm still thinking about them to this day, and hoping to apply a lot of those lessons to my personal practice.